Welcome to the Lady of Good Counsel and the funeral for Bob. Please stand.
Good morning, everyone. We begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you. As our brother Bob has died with the Lord, so may live with him in glory.
gathering song is number 744, Eternal Father is Strong to Save, number 744, verses 1 and 4.
Let us pray. God of our ancestors in faith, by the covenant made on Mount Sinai, you taught your people to strengthen the bonds of family through faith, honor, and love. Look kindly upon Bob, a father who sought to bind his family to you. Bring him one day to our heavenly home where the saints dwell in blessedness and peace through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. At this time, I invite Anthony to come forward and share with us our first read. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples. On this mountain, he will destroy the veil that veils all peoples, the web that is woven over all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces. The reproach of his people will remove from the whole earth, for the Lord has spoken. On this day it will be said, behold our God, to whom we look to save us. This is the Lord for whom we looked. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Great things, no good thoughts. beyond me.
At this time, I invite Sue to come forward and share with us our second reading.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Thessalonians. We do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus, bring with him those who have fallen asleep. Indeed, we tell you this, on the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will surely not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself, with the word of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, will come down from the heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are left alive will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, console one another with these words, the word of the Lord.
Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Please be seated. Bob was born in Endicott on February 22nd, 1935, and he's a member of the Union Endicott Class of 55. He went on to get a degree in nursing from Broome Community College and served the bulk of his professional life serving others as a nurse at Wilson Hospital. He also worked at Binghamton Savings Bank and was a substitute teacher and football coach at Susquehanna Valley High School. But Bob is unique in that he had the opportunity to serve in three branches of service. He served in the Army, in the Navy, and the Marine Corps. And he continued his service with the Marines for many years as part of an organization that reaches out to fellow Marines. He served in positions both locally and nationally, as they reached out and working together to build a community of fellowship among the Marines, and also to reach out to those Marines in the community to help them, to assist them in a variety of different ways. And so, you know, Bob really had a servant's heart in his work with the Marine community. He really had a great impact wherever he served, both locally and nationally. And we're very grateful for Bob's service. But along his journey, Bob meets this young woman named Jenny. Now, I'm sure in that first meeting, little did he know that together he and Jenny would share 58 years of their lives together in raising their family. And then after Jenny had died, Bob meets his fiance, Patty, and together they shared 2.5 years together. Now, if you asked Bob's family or friends about some of his hobbies or interests, then I'm sure they would all say that this is a guy that enjoyed a good cigar on occasion. He enjoyed his fellowship with his fellow Marines. And, of course, he had a great fondness for his dog, Sina. He was just a big animal, a little Franciscan, a little St. Francis in his heart, apparently. But if you ask Bob, you know, what was it that gave the most satisfaction and fulfillment? What was it that gave the most joy in his life? I believe he would immediately respond, well, of course. It was certainly his gift of faith, but also the love that he shared with his wife, Jenny, for those 58 years, the love he shared with his fiancée, Patty, and his two children, Cheryl and Terry, and two stepchildren, Slobrinda and Tyler, and, of course, the two grandsons and 7 step-grandchildren, and all of the extended family and friends that Bob met along the way. There's an interesting aspect of this gift of love, and that's this gift of love is eternal, which means that the love that we experience and the love that we share, it's that great gift that keeps the memories alive in our heart that go on before us. And for those who knew Bob and loved him, yes, this is a time of sorrow, and yes, this is a time of having to say farewell. But it's not a final goodbye, because this is not the end of Bob's story. Just as when Jesus died on the cross, that was not the end of his story. That we have eyewitness testimony that Jesus rose from the dead. And in his resurrection, he invites us to share in his resurrected life. And it's a life of goodness and peace, a life of joy and fulfillment, and most profoundly, it's a life of love. And so we can take great solace that recognizing that this is not the end of Bob's story, that there is a new chapter that's beginning. And we can take great solace in the readings that we had this morning. In this first reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Isaiah lived about 750 years before the birth of Jesus. And what we have in this short passage is an image of the glories of heaven, that there is this experience where death is destroyed forever, and that he's going to remove the veils, and that there will be no more suffering, there will be no more tears, there will be no more sorrow. And this gives us great hope of the joys of being in the presence of God for all eternity. And then you combine that with today's gospel, it's the famed Beatitudes. And the scene is that Jesus is traveling along and thousands of people had come out to see him. Some had heard that he was a dynamic preacher and teacher, others that he was this incredible miracle worker, and I'm sure there were others that were just following the crowd to see what this man was all about. And in that moment, Jesus takes the time to teach them. And what he teaches them is how his ministry that he is conducting is going to continue after he returned to the Heavenly Father. And what he's really saying is that his ministry is going to continue because we are called to be the hands and the heart and the voice and the feet of God. That we are the ones that are going to be continuing his ministry that he began. And we hear this passage, you know, blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. So the obvious question is, well, who's going to be doing the comforting? Well, ultimately, it's God, but God is depending upon you and I to reach out to our brothers and sisters who are in pain, to reach out to our brothers and sisters who are mourning and suffering, that we are to be the hands and the voice and the heart of God in the world. And I believe the family chose this particular reading because in his own way, this is the way Bob lived his life. Professionally, both serving those in the hospital, serving those who are sick, they're serving those who are in need. And it is also a professional life, is working with the Marine community, reaching out to those, kind of building up a community and helping those who are in need. And so we gather this morning in part to give thanks and praise to Almighty God for the great example that Bob has given us in his selfless service to others. We also gather in great prayer that we know that we have this loving God who listens and answers our prayers. And so we gather in prayer this morning for Bob, that at this very moment, that he'd be welcomed home, that he'd be shown his seat at the great banquet table, and then he gets to hear our loving words from a loving Savior that we all long to hear at the end of our own earthly journey. You know, well done, my good and faithful servant.
And we bring our petitions before our loving and merciful God.
Please respond, Lord, hear our prayer. For Robert, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Robert, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that he may be raised up on the last day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those in Robert's family who have passed, especially his wife Jenny, Benny DiLorenzo Sr., Michael DiLorenzo, Butch Neira, and Mary Ann Neira, that they may rejoice with the choir of angels in the heavenly Jerusalem, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Robert's family and friends, that in their grief they may be consoled by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have served or presently serve in the armed forces, that their sacrifice of time and labor may bring justice and equality to all God's people, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who work in professions of service to others, especially healthcare workers, that their work may continue to bring relief and comfort to others under the inspiration of Christ the Healer, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For us here today, and for all members of our church, that we may be prepared for the hour of our death, when God will call us by name to join him in his heavenly kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving God, we are confident that you hear and answer all of our prayers. We ask these prayers this morning, as we ask all things, through Christ our Lord. Please be seated. This time, I invite Patty and Terry to bring up our gifts.
Our song as the gifts are being presented is number 441 on Eagle's Wings, number 441.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for praise and glory of God's name, for our good and good of God's holy church.
Please stand. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Bob, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, O Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For even though by our own fault we perish, yet, by your compassion and your grace, when seized by death according to our sins, we are redeemed through Christ's great victory, and with him called back into life. And so, with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty, without end, we acclaim. Please kneel or be seated.
You are made holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Douglas, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Bob, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he, who is united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, in the name of God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Together we stand, and at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lord, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
For Catholics, communion is one of our signs of our unity of faith. Those who are not Catholic, give us financial. Please refrain from receiving communion. But let us all pray that we gather as one around God's table at some time to come. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Communion songs number 325, Bread for the World, number 325.
Let us pray. Please stand. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Bob may come to the eternal banquet of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. This time, I invite everyone to be seated for just a moment. And I invite Bob's daughter, Cheryl, to come forward and share with us some words of remembrance.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
My name is Cheryl, and I'm Bob's oldest daughter. On behalf of my family, we would like to thank you all for being here today to honor and celebrate the life of my father, Bob Neira. We are here to remember the man he was, the life that he lived, and the legacy he leaves behind. Dad was born on February 22, 1935. He was born the oldest son of Ovidio and Emily Neira. He grew up here, right here in Endicott, with his younger sister Barb and brother Butch. My Aunt Barb would be a constant presence in his life. She is the glue that held this family together. Dad enjoyed his weekly FaceTime calls with Aunt Barb during his Saturday breakfast with his mimosas, and when she would help him with a recipe that he would be making from time to time. My dad and his brother Butch shared the love for golf, and they both loved their food, especially when they were able to enjoy their sister's cooking. One might say they were two of a kind in many ways. Dad's high school years right here at UE High School, where he graduated in 1955, marked the beginning of a journey that would take him far and wide. After he finished his education, Dad enlisted in the United States Marine Corps, where he served his country with dedication and pride. It was during these years that he met the love of his life, my mom, Jenny. They became husband and wife on June 2, 1962, and together they built a beautiful family. As parents, they were devoted to their two daughters, myself and my sister, Terry. As a family, we shared many wonderful memories together. Dad believed in the importance of tradition, and whether it was family vacations or holiday dinners, he made sure that every moment was filled with love. Dad would also continue to serve his country for many years in the Army and Navy Reserves. After he retired from the workplace, Dad stayed active in his community. He spent time as a substitute teacher, and he became an assistant football coach at Susquehanna Valley High School, where he continued to give back, sharing his wisdom with the next generation. He was still in contact with and is remembered by many of the coaches and players today. Dad had two grandsons. He adored these grandsons. In 1992, my sister's son, Kenny, would be the first one born. My parents would get to babysit him quite often, and they developed a very special bond. It was with the birth of Kenny that my dad would become affectionately known as Pop-Pop. In 1994, grandson number two would arrive, and my son Adam would be born. Adam enjoyed spending time with his Pop-Pop, and as he got older, Dad would enjoy cheering Adam on the soccer field. Dad was very proud of both of his grandsons and enjoyed having them around. He took great interest in what was going on in their lives and supported them in any way he could. For 58 years, my dad and mom shared a love partnership built on respect, laughter, and mutual support. In their long journey together, he was not just a loving husband, but a friend and a caregiver. During my mom's battle with ALS, he became her rock, providing unwavering care, comfort, and tenderness every day. His dedication to her was a testament to the depth of love and devotion, never once faltering, even in the toughest of times. Together, they created beautiful memories in their longtime home in Kirkwood and eventually in their home in Pennsylvania. And many of those people from the lake down in Pennsylvania, they're here today to support and honor my dad. After my mom's passing, my dad found a second love in his fiancée, Patty, who brought new joy and companionship into his life. He embraced her family with open arms. Patty's daughter, Serelda, and her husband, David, and her son, Tyler, and his wife, Heather, became a cherished part of his life. He He enjoyed the presence of Patty's grandchildren, Austin, Elijah, Cole, Madison, Jackson, Aubrey, and Kinley, who added new layers of happiness to his days. In this new chapter, my dad experienced the joy of a second family, and it was clear that love and connection continued to fill his heart. Dad also had another love in his life, a friend, a companion that was always by his side, and that was his loyal dog, Sarah. She was very dedicated to him, and they did everything together. She gave him great comfort after my mom had passed away, and she continues to be a source of comfort today. My dad's life was also marked with his commitment to something even greater. His service to the United States Marine shaped much of who he was, a man of integrity, discipline, and honor. He carried the values instilled in him by the Corps throughout his entire life, always showing up with strength and pride, whether in uniform or in his daily life. Before moving to Illinois, he served as a member of the John W. Thurston Detachment right here in Binghamton, and he was the Commandant in the Endless Mountain Detachment in Halstead, PA. He currently served as a member in the Lincoln Land Leatherneck Detachment 1174 in Greenville, Illinois. He was a big part of the Marine Corps League, both locally and nationally. He served in every role he played, in husband, caregiver, father, and Marine. My dad gave all of himself. His legacy is one of deep love, unwavering duty, and strength that continues to inspire everyone who has had the privilege of knowing him. We are all better for having him in our lives, and his memory will live on in our hearts. We love you, Dad. Semper Fi.
We have a tradition here at Our Lady of the Council that when one of our members die, we invite a loved one to inscribe his or her name in our book of remembrance, that we as a community of faith will always keep that individual in our thoughts and prayers. So at this time, I invite Cheryl to come forward and inscribe her father's name in our book of remembrance, so that we as a community of faith will always keep Bob in our prayers and assurance and hope that Bob be praying for us. Please stand as we conclude our celebration. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again with the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Thank you.
grants Father mercies to commend our brother Bob, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, you will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Bob in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ and are with you and our brother forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest. May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem.
Our sending forth song is number 745, America the Beautiful, number 745.